I'm called a Super Bowl. Rather than safe zones, you enjoy 2 hours in a putrid movie house. Rather than save sins from eternal flames, new 150,000 people die today.
Name.
fade in their beauty, but your word travels faithful and true. My hands on the pulse, I am listening, and the words come to life and they bloom. Ooh, your word is a lamp to my path. Ooh, your word is a lamp to my path. Let the power of your words dwell here richly, changing the ways that I see. Fill me with otherly wisdom, plant me deep like a tree by the stream. Dividing the lies from the truth.
Apostolic, I may have said something about it last time in passing. If you don't salivate, if you don't drool, something is amiss. This word needs to be restored to its original pristine meaning, or else we have had it, or else we condemn ourselves to being merely charismatic, and God's jealousy over you is for much more than that. So the Greek word apostolos means sent. And that's the word that the scriptures use for Moses in the Old Testament, because the anatomy of this, the nub of it, the genius of it, is consistent and the same throughout all the dispensations of God. Moses was apostolic. The word is not used, it's a Greek word. But everything that he was, and the whole origin, and his sending, his calling, lays bare the heart of what it means to be sent, what it means to be apostolic. His brethren would have understood how that God by his hand would deliver them, but they understood not. So evidently one of the components of being apostolic is a certain dimension of rejection, even from those whom you're called to deliver. It's part of the paradox of the faith, and one that we need to expect and to bear. I have seen the affliction of my people, which is in Egypt, or New York City, or Asia, or the world over. And I have heard their groaning, and I am come down to deliver them. And now come, I will send thee into Egypt. Then Moses, whom they refused, saying, who made thee ruler and a judge? The same did God send. You underline every time you see the word send. The same did God send to be a ruler and deliverer by the hand of the angel which appeared to him in the bush, and he brought them out. Will not be sent except we can communicate in going something of the sense of God as he in fact is. Not what we think him to be. Not the little patsy that we have made him in our image to do our bidding, but God as he awesomely is and demands to be made known. There'll be no bringing out of Egypt. There'll be no deliverance out of bondage, except those who can come to men out of the presence of God and communicate that God as he has chosen to reveal himself, the God of the consuming fire in the bush that burns but is not consumed. Now we need to note where that bush is located, because it's in the same place still. It's on the Mount of God on the backside of the desert. And I want to say that you're disqualified from this encounter with God and the sending that comes from the meeting of him there if you're not to be found in that place. That you'll receive invitations, and they are already coming, to draw you to the front side, to the side where prestige and esteem and honor of men and acknowledgement by men